Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining me today, and thank you to Tamara of the Paper and Pen Girl for including me in this collaboration once again. Today we are going to be talking about planner funks and planner ruts. I feel like we've all been there, done that. If you're part of this planning community, you've probably been on your own personal planning journey that has at some point involved you being displeased with your current planning system. So what is a planner rut and a planner funk, and are they the same? To me, they kind of are. Usually when you're in a planner rut or a planner funk, you're just kind of going through the motions with your planner. You're sometimes not using your planner because you're not finding it very effective for the things that you need to do and get done in your life, in your work life, personal life, all of those things. It's just not working for you. And honestly, you may have just found planning to be completely boring and not motivating or inspiring or even bringing you joy anymore. So, have I ever experienced a planner rut or a planner funk myself? Abso-freaking-lutely. I feel like it happens almost seasonally for me, and normally it happens when I realize that I'm no longer reaching for my planner, or I'm more motivated and inspired by creating lists on a piece of paper or a post-it because my planner just isn't doing it for me, or I find it to be more difficult or more of a roadblock to plan in my planner with stickers and washi than I do just to make a list in a plain notebook. Honestly, over the years, the things that I've done when I've recognized that I have been in a planner funk or a planner rut is I ask myself, what is it about this current system that I no longer find effective, that I'm no longer gravitating towards? Like, what are the roadblocks? Is it specifically the planner itself, or is it the season of life that I'm in that it is no longer fitting? I think the most important part of recognizing that you're in a planner funk or planner rut is truly acknowledging it, right? Like, this is no longer working. Once you have done that, I think the next step is going to be to figure out what parts of the planner aren't working. Is it actually the planner, or is it actually your life that is not working with the planner? Sometimes those two things need to be in harmony, or else you're using a planner system that isn't functioning well enough for your life, or it's too small, or it's too big because you just don't have a lot going on. So it's a lot of those things that you have to take into account. For example, if you are really struggling with meal planning in the planner community, in our sort of hyper consumerism way that we have, what we like to do when we have an issue with meal planning is go out and buy this new shiny thing thinking that that is going to solve the problem, when in fact we've already had a system that could help us with our meal planning. We just tend to think that the solution is to introduce something new and shiny, that that is always the fix, and that's always what's gonna get us out of a funk, and that's not necessarily the case. Sometimes you have to take your current tool or your current planner and see where you can fit in that piece that is missing. You're struggling with meal planning, you have this planner that has this beautiful monthly view that you hardly touch. Where could your meal planning go? And obviously that depends on if, in this particular example, if you have room in your monthly spread. That could be a way to try and see if your meal planning is going to help you by using the current system that you have to integrate that into it. Now, of course, if your planner just isn't working, it just isn't working, and it's okay to try new things. But I highly encourage you to just, you know, grab a notebook, sit down, and figure out what it is that you need out of your planner. Do you need to keep track of kids' sports, kids' doctor's appointments, school schedules, your own work meetings and appointments, your own medical schedules, your meal planning, all of your other day-to-day things, and figure out exactly what that needs to look like specifically for you. The easiest way to get yourself into a planner funk or a planner rut is to see a system that is highly effective and working really, really well for someone else on social media. Sometimes it can be our own worst enemy. And you take a look at that system that's working perfectly for someone else and having that same expectation in your own life. We all lead very individual, unique lives. So when you are looking at other people's planning systems on social media, make sure to take into account that their life isn't going to be exactly like yours. So when you go and you buy this new shiny thing and you try to make it work exactly how they do, you might run into some roadblocks, and then you're just creating a whole new planner rut and planner funks. So definitely approach social media with the thought process that what someone else is using may not look exactly the same for you. definitely try it out, especially if your current system is just a complete total flop, but just keep that in mind. Another thing to keep in mind when you are in a planner funk or planner rut and you go to try something totally new is to consider the amount of time that you have given to this new thing. You're going to try out this new planner. It's not going to be perfect right away sometimes, but don't immediately abandon that system and then jump to yet another system. Give it a fair amount of time. My estimate would be at least, at minimum 1 month, but I would at least give it 3 months to see if you've tried to work with it in all of its different ways, its binding, its paper, things like that. You really need to give it time and see if this planner is actually going to fit in your life and if it's actually going to work. And again, I always talk about grabbing that notebook once again if you run into some roadblocks, keeping some notes on what didn't work with that particular system. For example, for me, years and years and years ago, I used a small personal rings planner like from Filofax that worked for me back then during that season of life. Fast forward a few years later, I tried it again and I tried it again and I tried it again and it just didn't work till finally I came to the realization that I just no longer needed to try out that system just to see if it worked. Sometimes trying out new systems costs a lot of money to set up, so that's another thing to consider. If you spend a lot of money on a system and it ends up not working for you, that can create way more than a planner funk, and we just don't want to do that, right? So let's talk about some ways that you can completely avoid a planner funk or a planner rut. As I said before, you're going to want to make sure that you give your system that you're currently using a fair shot. If there's a particular part of it that's not working, try to brainstorm some ideas to see exactly how you can make it work before jumping to a totally new system and spending a lot of money. The second thing I recommend to avoid a planner funk or a planner rut is, again, like I said earlier, is not to compare your experience and your system and your life to someone else's that you see on social media. You might see what looks like a absolutely perfect planner to someone else, but it just might not be a perfect fit for you and your personal needs. And another thing that I would consider is, how long are you going to need this particular system before you go investing tons of money into it? So a great way to avoid falling into a huge money pit, thus ending up in another planner rut or planner funk, is to try some systems that are undated or have a much smaller time frame, like a 6 month book or a quarterly book. That could work especially for really busy seasons of life. So if you know that you don't need a daily planner all year long, maybe consider getting a quarterly, daily, or a half year daily that works in a much smaller time frame. There are lots of companies that offer them out there, and it can also save you a ton of money. And last but certainly not least is to remember that it is completely okay to be in a planner rut or a planner funk. The most important thing is to recognize when you are in one and see what you can do about it. Everyone's planner journey is going to be completely different than the next person, so also keep that in mind. And just remember that planning should be fun and it should be helpful for your life. Once again, thank you to Tamara for including me in this year's collab of 25 days of planner tips. Make sure that you check out Mrs. Thinking of a Master Plan in the next video of this series. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. Once again, I am Julie of Julie's Plans. And if you are not already subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that red notification bell so that you know when my videos are posted here on YouTube. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, everyone.